It's the new Red Green Show! And now, here's the man with the spring in his step ever since his pocket watch exploded in his pants, your hero, my Uncle Red Green!
All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. I'm gonna get the show going right away here because I'm already late for the monthly Possum Lodge poker game.
Oh, brother, bunch of overweight guys drinking beer, smoking cigars. How can you call that fun?
Well, you won't be there, so that's a start.
You're all a bunch of shirkers. You're just shirking your responsibility by playing poker. Shirker, 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 shirker. Shameless shirker. Shirking your responsibilities. Go play cards. Indulge in stupid, pointless stories full of exaggeration and innuendo.
You know, for a guy who's never been there, you're an awful good guesser.
Well, if that's what being an adult is all about, I hope I never grow up.
That can be arranged. What you're looking at here is a bunch of segments from this particular show. The main message being, for gosh sakes, don't even think about changing the channel. I'll tell you something. If you're gonna try and make sense out of this program, you gotta give it your undivided attention.
Oh, the poker game break up early? I see you still have your shirt.
I just can't believe it, Harold. I was winning all night. And it comes down to the last hand, put the whole works on the line.
I'm sensing it didn't go well.
It's my favorite game, too. Odd man out. 3, 5, 7s, and 9s are wild, plus the one-eyed jack's the man with the axe. So I'm sitting there with 11 queens. Not gonna let on or nothing, you know, just kind of play it cool. So, stinky bets, I raise, Buster raises, Moose folds, so does the chair he's sitting on. Then stinky raises again, I raise again, Buster calls, eh? I lay down my 11 queens. Buster had a full house, 5, 8s, and 6, 9s. So I'm reaching for the pot. Stinky lays down 12 aces, clean me right out.
You know, Uncle Red, if you played with fewer wild cards, you know, you'd have less chance of someone getting 12 aces.
Harold, he didn't have any, okay? There were 12 natural aces.
Uncle Red, there's only 4 natural aces in a deck, aren't there?
Well, around that, I mean, I'd like to take an extra one just in case, you know. Some of the other guys, maybe. But there's never more than 5 or 6 extra aces. Oh.
Yeah, well, see, well, Stinky had 12, and yeah. There's only 4. That means he brought 8.
Somebody's cheating. Well, now, later on in the show, we're going to be doing a little bit of fruit picking with 2 guys who are perfect for the job. Bill and Harold there, and that's kind of a pretty classy-looking ladder there, but the operator is at about the same level as usual. And this is one of the old traditions around the... There's no bottom in that, Bill. One of the old traditions around the lodge is just to, you know, forget about the mechanized... Oh, forget about the the mechanical equipment and so on. Because it's just so much more fun to just be, you know, picking the fruit by hand. As you can see, it's going to take a long time to fill that basket. So Harold comes back, and it's, I guess, Revenge of the Nerds. Is he? There we go. By golly, eh? Hey, they just say fruit's not good for you. What? Oh, my gosh, it's Watermelon Man. Oh, the moon is a strange shade of yellow, with stripes of magenta and blue. The clouds are purple and orange, and the mist smells like an old shoe. Oh, I have a horrible headache, and I pass out every minute or two. It's okay to have a bonfire, but not in a fiberglass canoe.
Okay, this is for the big one. The grand prize of a bent stop sign and a coupon for a free driving lesson. Uncle Red, you have 30 seconds to get Mr. Dougie Franklin to say this word. Pep. Pep. Oh, no. Engel.
All right, Dougie.
Yeah?
A dog.
Friend.
No, it's more than a friend. It's a...
family member.
Well, that may very well be, but then, okay, how about this? Cat.
Bulldozer.
All right, let's go another way on this. You know, when we were young, we wouldn't make out with girls. We wouldn't neck with girls. We would...
We'd cry.
No. The word we used instead of make out was...
Lie.
All right. You get senior citizens, you know, and they get kind of lonely. A lot of doctors will recommend they get a...
Lobotomy.
We're almost out of time, Uncle Red. I'm happy to report.
Budgies and parakeets. Yeah. These are common household...
Pests.
Oh. Okay, you take a pest, you take the sss out of it, and what you have is a...
You got a bladder problem out of it. And, you know, with monster truck drivers, that's got to be one of our pet peeves.
You know, last week for our anniversary, I gave my wife, Bernice, the entire James Bond film library on video cassette. Should have seen her face. Shaken, not stirred. Then, of course, later on that evening, Bernice was up, sleeping upstairs there, snoring like a banshee, and I was about halfway through my third big film there, and I noticed Agent 007 strapped on one of them rocket jetpacks and just took off. Whoosh, like that. Man, unbelievable. Just like the time Moose Thompson fell off the roof. Except backwards. As soon as I saw that jetpack, I knew what I had to build for this week's Handyman Corner. Forget about traffic jams, parking spaces, and stop signs. Get yourself a rocket jetpack. Here's all you need. Get yourself a fuel tank of some kind. Get some rocket fuel in there. Get a fuel control valve. You're gonna need a fuel igniter, and you're gonna need some kind of a rocket nozzle. Some sort of a metal frame there to hold it all together. And of course, a crash helmet. Now, you can get this stuff from them former Soviet Union rocket scientists. They'll smuggle it out of the country for a few thousand dollars. Or you could just look in your garage. Personally, I'm leaning towards the garage. Actually, the garage is leaning towards me. There we go. Or as the French would say, viola. All right, now, first thing you want to look at is your fuel tank. I'm gonna go with the double tank on this. I'll tell you, me flying up there 17,000 feet, having to stop for fuel, that would be inconvenient. Plus, you don't see James Bond running out of gas every half hour, which is probably how he gets all those women. All right, for your hoses and your rocket nozzle and everything, just use everything comes in the barbecue. Your 3-2-1 ignition, you got the barbecue starter right there. Your vertical thrust, you got your burner control knobs on there, I guess. Come off with a wrench of some kind, I would think. And you're gonna need a metal framework to hold the whole thing together. I would just use this part of the unit right here. What you want to do is form that together and strap her on your back. You could use seat belts for that, or heavy rope, or if you want it to be real safe, I recommend the handyman's secret weapon, duct tape. And just relax, take it easy, hey? You don't have to be a rocket scientist. Just like that. All right, now you're ready to take all your rocket equipment and put it on there. You got your fuel lines attached to your fuel tanks, and they go up, attached in through your fuel regulators here, and then on to your rocket nozzles. Now, what you want to do there is just hook them on the back of the... You know, I feel like that guy that makes all James Bond equipment. What's his name? Q. Yeah, and his letter's Q, too. I feel like Q. I look like Al. It's bar humor. Here we go. And there I have my very own personalized James Bond jetpack. Now all I need is a flying helmet, or a crash helmet, as the pessimists call it. And for that, I'm gonna just use this unit right here. Hey, look at that. Doesn't that just scream safety and secret agent and spying and danger? Just pop that baby on. Ah, perfect, isn't it? I'm the spy who came in from the coals. Now we just turn on our
rocket power. Lost one of my knobs there. There we go. And when I want to take off, I just hit the ignition button. So remember, if women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. I gotta fly.
I see why they have to keep getting new actors to play James Bond. Stay tuned and relax. Whatever this is, we got a lot more of it. I want to talk to you guys about what you should tell your kids about life. See, now, in my day, fathers didn't talk that much to their kids. But the only advice my dad ever gave me was, don't slouch like that. It wasn't much, but it meant a lot. You know, I think now I kind of wish that my dad had maybe given me a little more advice. Not that the slouching thing wasn't really terrific, you know, but maybe he could have taught me about career or money or marriage or women or relationships, something along that line, you know. Of course, now it's too late because dad has left us. He's gone to live in Florida. But I was sitting here thinking, you know, what could I tell the people of today to tell their youngsters, you know, something that would help them out, you know? And I think of the one thing, one piece of advice that would have saved me a lot of grief and time and money. And I know what it is. Take care of your teeth. Yeah. Friends come and go, families come and go, jobs come and go. But when you're built like I am, you're gonna use these babies 5-6 times a day. So you fellas out there, you take your youngsters aside, sit them down and say, hey, take care of your teeth. What the heck, they're not gonna listen to you anyway. Remember, I'm pulling for you. We're all in this together. Come on over here, Harold, take a look at this.
What?
How many cards in a deck?
What, like a normal deck?
Yeah, normal deck of cards.
Well, it
yeah.
depends. Well, you see, it depends, because yeah. like in a euchre deck, there's less cards, right, than yeah. there is in a normal deck. Can I ask that there's more cards than there is in a normal deck? That's weird, too, huh? Old mate, they're bizarre, old mate. They got, like, you know, like the seven of donkeys and the ace of dragons and stuff. I don't know what's going on there. Regular decks, sometimes they can have, like, two more cards. Maybe they're jokers. And then there's, like, an instruction card and a warranty card. Sometimes there's a blank card. I don't even know what that is. Like, that's a blank.
Oh! 52
cards. Yeah. With regular deck, sure, 52, yeah.
So I counted up the cards we were playing with in the poker game. Comes in 94.
94?
Yeah.
Supposed to be 52. That's a lot of extra jokers.
Yeah. 18 extra.
More or less, yeah.
And that's not counting these, Harold.
Whoa! Yeah. You think maybe the card table came like that?
Well, you came like that, so I guess anything's possible. Well, Harold, here's something else. Stinky happened to be sitting on this side of the table. Stinky happened to win the entire pot. I think this may be more than a coincidence here.
And here's another clue, Uncle Red. These cards are all stuck on with that weird gum that Stinky chews.
No, that's his saliva.
But, oh! State your name and our membership number, please.
It's Sherwood. And I lost my membership card, but I got a card from the video store.
All right, that's good enough. Where are you calling from, Buzz?
Well, that's just it, Redman. I don't know where I am. I'm lost.
Oh, well, okay, let's find out. Are you in your car or are you in your plane?
Let me check. Dingle balls. Ground sort of close.
That means he's in his plane.
Car! I'm in a car!
He's in a car!
All right. Okay, Buzz. What do you see around there?
Trees and a hill. Is that familiar to you guys? Hilly and trees.
Yeah. Are there any people around there?
I see a guy up ahead. He's fixing his mailbox. Oh, man. Oh, that's the one I hit earlier. Oh. I'm going around in circles, Red.
No, look, Buzz. Keep calm now.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to go up to that guy and you're gonna have to ask him for directions.
Ask for directions? How does that work, man?
Don't panic, Buzz. Do not panic. We'll coach you through this.
Yeah. All right, listen, Buzz. The directions are gonna be too complicated for you to remember, all right?
So just listen to the first few things he says and get an idea of the direction he's pointing in, okay? Then just keep nodding your head until he says, you can't miss it, all right?
Yeah.
And then just say, so I was right, and take off. Well, here we are with Adventures with Bill, and as I said earlier, we weren't gonna go with the mechanized, but here now, look what we got. We got the mechanized, Bill's on the mech, look at that thing, beautiful thing. It's called a stick loom, and this is something that you you youngsters might be interested in. Bill started as a youngster, and I believe he had the Meccano and the Lego and the various other O's. And now he's graduated up the ladder there. Well, not a ladder, really. It's, as I say, a stick loom.
Yeah.
And what you find with that is, as so many and so many examples of life, you mechanize things, and you get a machine that can do the work of four or five men. I don't know who the men are in this particular case. Not bright men, I would say, but what you can do, you can pick the fruit not just from the underneath, but from the sides and also on the top of the tree, and Billy just, all you gotta do is grab that, and all right, now you can, now in the manual it says, don't grab that lever too hard, because it has a tendency to come out, and, well, you're not gonna do a lot of fruit picking up in that area, are you? Try over by the barn. Can you climb? No, you can't climb. What's? Oh, no. All right, there we go. There we go. Harold, there's no bottom in there. Oh boy, he's up there. All right. Well, this is another example of machinery helping us through life. There you go. I guess it's the end of his shift. You got him, Harold. Oh, lost him in the sun. Oh boy. Oh boy. And keeping with the tone, here's a stuffed cat from our friends at WTVP 47 in Peoria.
Got too much starch in your shirt, Uncle Red?
Fine, Harold. Got the cheating problem all straightened out, and I'm all set for the rematch with Stinky on the poker. Just the two of us, eyeball to eyeball, winner take all.
Oh, cool. Yeah, like Brett Maverick, frontier gambler, huh? Or Paul Newman in The Sting. Remember that? Remember that? He played poker against Robert Shaw on the train. He was Henry Gondorf, and he burped really loud. You know what you need to beat, Stinky? You know what you need? A good poker face. I don't have a good poker face.
Well, I'll bring it over here. Let me poke it for you.
No, but really though, how are you gonna beat Stinky? How are you gonna do it? You've been taking poker lessons?
No, I don't need poker lessons.
No, you do. You do, because.
No, I don't. Oh man.
You were gonna cheat!
No, Harold.
He was gonna cheat! It's no wonder my generation's so cynical. I hope you are very proud of yourself, young man.
Gotta go, Harold.
You got cards in your pants!
It's like a straight flush.
No, hell no. Full house.
Hey, welcome to the expert portion of the show, where we examine those three little words that men find so difficult to say.
I don't know.
I don't know. Okay, now, joining me, Uncle Red, in the expert portion of the show this week is his best friend in the whole wide room, local roofer, Arnie Dogan. Okay, this week's letter goes as follows. Dear experts, I have a string of unsuccessful careers. I was a urea formaldehyde salesman. Then I invested in my life savings in Pogs, thinking they could only increase in value. And currently, I'm a travel agent for Value Jet. Is the whole world against me or what?
No. Before the world's going to be against you, you're going to have to meet a lot more people. Just ask Harold.
Hey.
Now, in my experience, the world is never against you. In the roofing business, we know that you only got three natural enemies: wind, gravity, and wet shingles.
How is the leg, Mr. Dogan?
Oh, it's healing good. They were going to put a steel pin in it, but I already got a chunk of aluminum in there from the time I landed on Buster Hadfield's TV antenna. But you'll never hear anyone down at Dogan & Sons Roofing complaining and whining that the world's against us. No, like when my dad dropped 60 feet onto the roof of that Ford Fairlane, he was just glad it was a convertible.
Well, the driver wasn't too thrilled about it. Neither was his widow.
No, but I think it's a healthy attitude you have. I mean, you're taking responsibility for life.
That's it, yeah. You know, and I wrote a song about that for my next CD.
You didn't have to do that, though.
label from Dogan Distributing. The album will be coming out as soon as we get that roofing contract down at the community center. Goes like this.
No, when... I heard it.
No, you haven't heard this one. This is a special new one. When you feel like a toad on the highway of life, and everyone seems like a steel-belted radio. When you're lying there squished in an assortment of body fluids, hey, at least you left your mark.
Well, I can't wait to see that video.
Good news is, whatever goes around comes around. I managed to win back everything I lost in the poker game.
Shame, shame. How about your honor? Yeah, huh? You lost that when you decided to cheat.
I was fighting fire with fire, Harold.
No, you were fighting fire with aces in your underwear. Shame, shame. You profited by deceit.
I didn't profit, Harold. I just broke even, plus a little bit, all right? And now we got a new agreement on cheating. You can only bring 5 extra cards, and you got to use them all in one hand.
It's meeting time, Uncle Red.
Yeah, you know, it's too bad you feel so bad about the cheating, because I was going to give you 10% of my winnings, but, you know, that's all right. I understand.
I'm frowning on it. I'm frowning. Well,
yeah.
This is a frown. I'm just saying that, 10% is very generous of you.
Really?
Yeah, it is, so I don't want to be rude.
There you go. Enjoy.
Toothpicks!
Yeah, toothpicks, yeah.
You're playing poker for toothpicks!
Yeah.
I thought you were playing for money.
Oh, no, you gotta have money to play for money, Harold, you know? My golly. Toothpicks in your pocket's a real killer, I'll tell you.
Ooh, they're all used!
Man, I was rolling. I could have won all of Stinky's matches, too, but he's got the wood stove. He didn't want him to freeze to death. You go ahead, Harold. I'll see you later.
All right. Toothpicks!
We'll spend them all in one mouth. And if my wife is watching, I'll be coming straight home after the meeting. And if you hear I was cheating, it was only during a poker game, so don't start thinking about things you can do to a sleeping man with 12,000 toothpicks. For the rest of you, thanks for watching. On behalf of myself and Harold and the whole gang up here at Possum Lodge, keep your stick on the ice. Sedgwick, who won the 4 cases of whiskey at Christmas, is now up and around again.
Wow.